Scout squads are space marines in training, not yet fully elevated to the ranks of battle brother. All are competent killers and infiltrators, wreaking havoc behind enemy lines and none better than the Raven Guard to send their finest into the battlefield. In this video, we'll be painting a scout sergeant in the chapter colours of the Raven Guard to battle ready. Then we'll add a few more paints and techniques to take your models to the next level. The paints we'll be using are on the screen right now for our Shadowy Marine. These colours are great for all of your Raven Guard in your collection. We also have a list of the additional equipment we've used, but you can use whatever brushes you feel most comfortable with and replace the mediums with water instead. If you're new to painting or want to brush up on your skills, you can check out the Citadel Colour Painting Essentials videos to learn all about paints and techniques. For our sergeant, we'll be using Chaos Black as our undercoat, as the majority of our colours are in a darker tone. So let's start painting our Raven Guard. To get our Raven Guard started, we'll be painting the cloth and the gloves with Storm Vermin Fur. If the shoulder pads have a scroll motif on it, we'll also use this colour to paint this detail as well. We'll apply a few thin coats to all the legs, torso, arms and gloves. As this colour is a layer paint, it may naturally be thinner, so only add a little water and apply 2 to 3 thin coats to get a solid finish. Don't worry about being messy at this stage, as we'll be painting over the rest of our details. We just want to make sure we get all that cloth covered before moving on. Next, we'll use Abaddon Black for the armour, hair, gun casing and boots. Just like with the rest of our colours, we want to make sure that we are neat now, as we'll be painting near that cloth. We should only need one coat over the black undercoat, but you may find that you need 2 if you're painting over any of that storm vermin fur that slipped onto the armour. You'll also only need to paint 1 of the knee pads too, as we'll be painting the other one later on. With our armour looking dark and clean, we can paint the leather belt and pouches with Rhinox hide. In this scout squad, you can add more pouches or a knife scabbard with the length of rope, so paint any of these details with this colour too. Some of these details are small, so we'll switch to a small layer brush so we can avoid making any mistakes as we paint. But don't worry if you do, we can tidy up with the last paints we used. In this scout squad, you can add more pouches or a knife scabbard with a length of rope, so paint any of these details with this colour too. Now our scout is looking a little bit more like a Raven Guard, so now we can add some metallics. For the weapon, piping, backpack and the comms details, we'll be using Iron Warriors. Some of these details are in different sizes, so you may find using a few brushes works best, like a small base brush for the chainsword and a small layer for the comms and piping. Just make sure you are neat and apply a few thin coats to get a nice dark metallic sheen. Then we'll paint the chainsword guard, scabbard details, bullets and skull icon with skull crusher brass. Just like with Iron Warriors, we want to make sure that we get a smooth but shiny finish, so make sure you let all your coats fully dry before applying the next. When you have finished painting your metallics, we'll change our paint water, so we can avoid getting any metallic flakes getting into our next colours. With our water changed, we can move on to Corax White for the chest eagle, face and that other knee pad. We'll need to apply 2 to 3 coats of this colour over the black undercoat or other colours, so just take your time. With the face, we want to avoid painting the inside of the mouth, as leaving it black is more natural, but we can pick out those teeth at the same time. But if you do get some of the white in the inside of the mouth or on his hair, we can just tidy those details back with Abaddon Black. This is a great stage in our painting to make sure that all of the colours we have applied are neat and tidy, as we'll be moving on to some contrasts and shades. Once that Corax White is dry, we can contrast the skin with a mix of 1 part Gilliman Flesh and 2 parts Contrast Medium. This will give us a pale skin that Raven Guard Marines have. Just apply it around the face, making sure it doesn't pull too heavily, but gets into all of those recesses, giving the tone we're after. You can also take some away whilst it's wet with a dry brush. And you can always add more afterwards once it's dry, with a small amount of the mix if needed. Now we'll apply Nuln Oil in 2 ways. We'll apply it straight out the pot for our Iron Warriors, Rhinox Hide and Storm Vermin Fur details. We can cover these details fully, making sure that we don't overwhelm the details and control any pooling. Then we'll thin down one part Norn oil with one part Lamium medium and apply it to the core XY details. Just like before, we want to apply it enough to cover, but not pull and slip off. And to finish off our model, we'll add a quick shade of Reichlin Flesh Shade to the Skull Crusher Brass. We'll use a small amount and a small layer brush, so we avoid the other colours. And there we are! Our Raven Guard Scout Sergeant is now battle ready, blending into the shadows, ready to infiltrate and ambush the enemies of the Imperium. You can stop here if you're happy with your sergeant, and paint the rest of your squad in the same way. Or you can carry on with these extra paints and techniques to take your model to the next level. For our armour and cloth, we'll use Dawnstone to highlight these colours. We'll make sure to get our point on our brush by rolling it on the palette after thinning our paint. This also controls how much paint we have on the brush too. We want to just pick out those edges on the armour with the side of the brush to help us keep a straight, consistent line. Then we can pick out the fold of the cloth more than anything, so we only need to add a few quick lines. Next, we'll highlight all our metals with Stormhost Silver. With this, you don't have to highlight every edge or detail. We just want to pick out the most visible or prominent. You can also add a few scratches on that chainsword too, adding a bit of combat experience behind our sergeant. Now we'll use Abaddon Black to paint the V marking on the white knee pad, and we can also paint the eyes too, as Raven Guard Marines have pitch black eyes. Just make sure that your small airbrush has a sharp point for these small details. Only do these steps if you feel comfortable with creating straight lines and dotting the eyes. If you don't, or you want to save time, you don't have to do this step. And for the white details, we can highlight these with White Scar. Just a few small lines to bring out those details on the chest eagle will really make it stand out against the pitch black armour. With those colours applied, our Raven Guard Scout Sergeant is looking amazing, ready for some close combat with striking scorpions. You can see we've finished the base in Martian Iron Crust, and if you'd like to learn more about basing your models, we have videos all about it. For more tutorials, tips and tricks, check out our videos on the Warhammer YouTube channel, or head to your local Warhammer store, where our amazing staff would be happy to help you. Well, we hope you enjoyed this video, and we'll see you next time. Bye bye!